Well, this does not seem right. Now this is a thermostat. And no, it is not boring. Keep watching. What it does is measuring the temperature in a room. And if that temperature is below a threshold that I set beforehand, then it closes a relay. And that activates a valve in my boiler room. This allows hot water to flow through my underfloor and heat everything up. Meaning it is part of my heating system, which actually does sound kind of boring. But here's what makes it so interesting. This thermostat here, for example, says 21.6°C, but my usual room thermometer claims 23.5°C, which another thermometer basically confirms. Long story short, my thermostats do a terrible job at measuring the correct temperature. And I've been noticing this problem since the installation 1 year ago. So in this video, it is finally time to change that by firstly finding out what is wrong with my thermostats and then coming up with a solution that will probably involve some slick hardware hacking. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Würth Elektronik, who provided the super accurate temperature ICs you will see in this video. And you can check them out for yourself by following the link in the video description. To get started, let me firstly tell you that I have a total of 10 of these thermostats installed. And I got myself the specific model, mainly because it was very cheap and comes with Wi-Fi. This way I can control each thermostat through my home assistant system everywhere in the world, which is quite useful. But of course, having wrong temperature readings is certainly not useful. So time to crack open a spare thermostat and see what is going on the inside. After taking everything apart, it seems like the bigger part houses the power supply and relay, and the smaller part is the control PCB. That does Wi-Fi, manages the LED display, touch input buttons, and most importantly measures the temperature with the small black component here, which is an NTC, and that stands for negative temperature coefficient. Let me show you what it can do by firstly unsoldering it. Now at a temperature of around 24°C, it comes with a resistance of 9.9 kilo ohm. Meaning we are apparently dealing with a 10 kilo ohm type here, that, like the name implies, comes with a resistance of 10 kilo ohm at 25°C. And when we cool it off, then its resistance increases. And as you probably already guessed, when we heat it up, then its resistance decreases. Sadly though, this resistance temperature relation is not linear. Instead, it follows a curve, which can be described with this formula. And after soldering the NTC back into its place and investigating the PCB further, I realized that we got a fixed 10 kilo ohm resistor in series to the NTC, as well as a capacitor in parallel. And since we got 5 volts and ground connected to it all, we are basically dealing with a voltage divider here that tells us the current temperature. For example, at my room temperature it is around 2.41 volts. And if it gets hotter, then the voltage decreases, and overall should follow a pretty linear relation between temperature and voltage. So what is the problem? I mean, this theory sounds pretty reasonable and precise. Well, there could be many reasons, like the tolerance of the NTC with its beta value, as well as the tolerance of the resistor. Also, self-heating of the NTC could play into this. Or the reference voltage might drift over time. This all could add up and make the temperature reading unreliable. So to fix this, I want to get rid of the NTC altogether and replace it with a digital temperature IC, like this tiny thing here from Würth Elektronik. This WSEN-TIDS comes with a big temperature range, is factory calibrated, utilizes I2C for communication, and best off, its absolute accuracy is only plus minus 0.25°C. Lovely! And you can even get it on a dev board for testing, which I simply hooked up to 3.3 volt power and the I2C pins of an ESP32. After then reading through its data sheets to find out how to communicate with it, I created some suitable code and thus got the temperature readings over the serial monitor pretty quickly. And in case you're wondering, you have to add a decimal point in the middle here to get the proper Celsius reading, which is pretty accurate, I would say. Awesome! But how to get these microcontroller readings into the voltage divider of the thermostat? The answer is, of course, this MCP 4725 IC here, which is a digital to analog converter that, like the name implies, takes our digital value and turns it into an analog voltage that the voltage divider would have created as well. To make sure that this will later work though, I got rid of the voltage divider on the thermostat and instead simply injected the voltage created by my lab bench power supply. And yes, as you can see, by changing the voltage in 0.1 volt steps, we get different readings on the display. By the way, I used this opportunity to write down what exact voltage created what display temperature, and it seems like a rather linear function that should be easy to work with. So my voltage injection plan should work just fine, considering that my DIC comes with a resolution of 12 bits, and thus can create voltage steps of 0.8 millivolts at 3.3 volts, which is more than enough. So to summarize, the temperature IC measures the temperature, a microcontroller receives this data and sends it over to the DIC according to the voltage display temperature charts, and ultimately the DIC creates the analog voltage. All that was left now was creating a schematic and PCB, which I did next, and in case you're wondering, these two ICs here are for one the ADTiny 402 microcontroller, which I chose because it is cheap and small, and the other one is a 3.3 volt regulator that takes the 5 volts from the thermostat and turns it into suitable 3.3 volts for power. And while designing the PCB, I was trying to make it as small as possible so that it fits right on the original PCB. And after I was done with it all, I gotta say that it came out pretty lovely and fits perfectly. So time to put solder paste onto the PCBs, place the components and let it all reflow solder with my hot plates. And once again, the result looked pretty promising, meaning time to firstly power it up with 5 volts through my lab bench power supply to make sure that nothing blows up, which luckily didn't happen. Next, I once again hooked up an ESP32 to the I2C lines to make sure that all my ICs are functioning correctly. So I firstly uploaded the example I2C scanner sketch that basically told me that both my temperature sensor and DIC are there. Next, I wrote some I2C code for the DIC, which should let it output a slowly increasing analog voltage. And as you can see on the voltage meter, that also seems to work perfectly fine. And by using the temperature reading sketch from before, I also got some pretty promising values. But here is where I noticed a tiny problem. You see, even by touching the PCB at the side without temperature sensor, it still quickly picks that up. The reason are the big copper pores in the PCB that obviously transfer heat very well, meaning I should either have created a little island for the temperature IC or kept it separate altogether. But we will see how it'll perform, because now it was finally time to connect my hardware hack PCB to the thermostat and create some final code that most importantly comes with a function that converts our measure temperature into the right voltage. After uploading that, the serial monitor shows us what temperature we are currently measuring, and I would say that is pretty spot on with the display, and also in comparison to a proper thermometer. That means it was time for me to finish this all by gluing the hack PCB onto the control PCB, connect the outputs via a 5k resistor to the temperature voltage inputs, and hook up 5 volts and ground. Last but not least, I connected a UPDI programmer to my board and used that to flash the code onto the AD Tiny. And at this point, I was super happy to see that everything still worked just fine. But does it also work when installed onto a wall? Well, it apparently still works good enough, which I'm happy about. But let's face it, this is not the ideal solution, because it not only takes too much time to make, but it also would have made way more sense to let the digital temperature sensor talk to the thermostat microcontroller directly. But sadly, we do not have the firmware for it. So in conclusion, we learned that we should not go with the cheapest stuff, and that hardware hacking is not only fun, but also very useful. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If so, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!